Why does methylfolate act as the off switch for the glycine buffer system?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Jeff Huseby says, how does the body buffer excess methyl groups if the glycine buffer system is maximally suppressed by methylfolate and all methylation needs have been satisfied? If the answer is it excretes them, then why does it need the glycine buffer system in the first place? Can't it just excrete them without it? Well, it's cyclical. So, okay, how does the body buffer excess methyl groups if the glycine buffer system is maximally suppressed by methylfolate? You mostly have methylfolate in the fasting state, and you have MTHFR because, so this is how it works. In the fed state, that's where you're going to get your methylfolate, obviously, but you know, a given molecule of methylfolate goes through the cycle of becoming methylated like 18,000 times a day. So you have one out of 18,000 methyl groups attached to the methylfolate that you ate. And that methyl group is, you know, totally insignificant in the context of the, you know, total number of methyl groups that that particular folate molecule will experience in one day. Furthermore, it... yeah, it might help recycle homocysteine to methionine, but probably not, because all your new methionine comes in the fed state. So not all your methylfolate comes in the fed state, because you remethylate folate in the fasting state, but all your new methionine comes in the fed state. You don't get new methionine that is not recycled from homocysteine. You don't get new methionine coming in except during the fed state. And so during the fed state, your main source of methyl groups is the methionine that came in the protein that you ate. And so that methionine increases SAMe. That's why SAMe is a fed state molecule. It's not, that's not saying that there's no SAMe in the fasted state. There is, but SAMe goes up in the fed state and down in the fasted state. And so when SAMe goes up in the fed state, that does a couple things. It shuts off MTHFR. So after a meal, you don't use MTHFR at all. It also shuts down BHMT. Not sure if it shuts down choline dehydrogenase, but it might. So you're not using choline and betaine to remethylate homocysteine during the fed state. You are not recycling homocysteine, therefore, during the fed state. SAMe also increases CBS activity. So during the fed state, you are diverting most of your methionine into homocysteine catabolism to cysteine, and therefore to taurine, sulfate, maybe glutathione, depending on how much you need to synthesize, etc. And so the flux is methionine from the meat in your, or from whatever protein in your diet. It goes through one methylation reaction. It becomes homocysteine. It then goes through this transsulfuration pathway, becomes cysteine, and then goes on. That's the fed state. Because MTHFR is shut off, then you're not going to have much methylfolate. Yeah, you ate some methylfolate there, but you don't have much methylfolate there. And so methylfolate is not going to shut off the glycine buffer system. Glycine buffer system will be active under these conditions because your SAMe levels are high, and they're higher than what you need for most of the methylation reactions. And so also during the fed state, you're going to be using the glycine buffer system a lot. So in the fed state, methionine engages in a methylation reaction. That might be a methyltransferase for something that needs to be methylated. If you've exceeded the need for that,
which you probably have, then some of it's going to methylate glycine and then become homocysteine, then be catabolized to cysteine through the transsulfuration pathway. That's the fed state dynamic. The fasting state dynamic is that you aren't eating any protein, so you don't have any new methionine coming in, so your SAMe levels drop. SAMe levels dropping relieves the suppression of MTHFR and BHMT and allows the recycling of homocysteine. SAMe levels dropping essentially turns off the transsulfuration pathway, or at least it lowers the volume on that pathway. Because you now have lower SAMe, that's why you have more methylfolate, because that now MTHFR is active. And because of that, methylfolate is seen as a signal of the fasting state low SAMe dynamic. And because of that, the glycine buffer system, or glycine N-methyltransferase, GNMT, interprets the methylfolate as that signal and says methylfolate is here. That must mean SAMe levels are low. That means I should go home and stop working. And so the glycine buffer system turns off. And so the answer is, you know, you asked, how does the body buffer excess methyl groups if the glycine buffer system is maximally suppressed by methylfolate and methylation needs have been satisfied? The body doesn't buffer the excess methyl groups if the glycine buffer system is maximally suppressed. When you have excess methyl groups, you don't have methylfolate to shut off the glycine buffer system. So when you have excess methyl groups, that's when the glycine buffer system turns on. And when you don't have excess methyl groups, that's when it turns off. If the answer is it excretes them, then why do we need the... Well, yeah, it's not that it excretes them. And the glycine buffer system, it's not about excreting the methyl groups. It's... you know, as an analogy to a chemical buffer is something that will, a pH buffer, for example, is something that will prevent you from going, you know, it'll keep you in a certain range of pH and it'll prevent you going from going one or extreme or the other. Glycine system is sort of like a biochemical buffer. And so to a certain extent, it can, those methyl groups can be salvaged in the mitochondria during the fasting state by taking them off of the methylated forms of glycine. It's only if you exceed the capacity to cleave them off that they do wind up in the urine. And they do wind up in the urine. So you generally do exceed to some extent the capacity to take those methyl groups. But the preference is to take them later, not to excrete them. The excretion is always going to be there, and it will increase if you really exceed the capacity of the buffer system to salvage them. All right. Thank you for your question, Jeff. Hope that helps.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The MasterPass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, The Ultimate Cheat Sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations.
please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.